We're going to now attach the wings to the back of the fairy. The way we do this is we're going to be using our colored pins, our plastic pins, but being that the piece of plastic that we made our wings from is very thick, we're going to want to make a small hole first so that the pins don't break. So I'm using an X-Acto knife, but any sharp point will do. And we go ahead and make a small hole in the center of the wings, and then take our pin and put it through, and then we can go ahead and attach it straight to the back of the fairy. And it goes in, it sits nice and secure. We could put glue on the end of the pin, but it's really not going to do much because the pin is very short and it's not going in too deep. So you don't really need any glue, you can just put it straight in. It's very sharp too, so it doesn't create a big hole when it's stuck inside the styrofoam. So now we've attached the wings to the back of the fairy, and we can go ahead and decorate them, or we can leave them like they are. You should also pay attention to the size of the wings, because you really want to be able to see them when you're looking straight at the fairy. You want to be able to see the wings from behind. So make sure that you make the wings big enough. There have been those that have done this project, and they've created a whole series of puppets just from the same technique with the styrofoam balls, and that was actually the way they made their puppets. They've either attached them with a stick on the back or with a string hanging, but they didn't necessarily make it so that it was a fairy puppet. But we're not going to make a whole series of puppets along this theme. We're going to make one special puppet of the fairy puppet. So I think that it's important to put the wings on and attach it to the string to make a little bit of a different type of puppet to liven up any kind of show that you might be putting on. So now I've shown you how to attach the wings to the back of the puppet.